Hi everyone and welcome back. So here this weekend we are going to finish up this Swiggy application. I mean it's going for a long time and I decided let's finish up whatever the microservices are left this week. So first we will try to understand the current state of the nation, like what all we have done. So if you look into this, what we have done is we just created a simple microservice like Swiggy microservice and Gatekeeper microservice. Gatekeeper is talking to the Firebase. Swiggy microservice is giving us some data from the database. We have Nginx for the routing. It's like simple proxy, acting as a proxy. Like you wanted to go to payment service, order service. You can decide based on the route on the Nginx and the front end will hit this request. We already have an integration with the Firebase at the Gatekeeper level or at the front end level, right? So you are going to send authorization header. That header will directly go to the microservice. Microservice will validate that authorization header or the token using this Gatekeeper service, which further going to talk to the Firebase. Okay, we have written this Swiggy microservice and this is our Docker Compose running. It will be up and running in some time and we will see everything is up and running. The UI you can run standalone. Now it's time to finish up the lot of things. Now what we are doing is we have this Gatekeeper service. This Gatekeeper service is using this environment variable, which is having all the environments of the Firebase, like the private key, database URL, and all the things. Okay, so I will also quick recap, okay, how to configure the Firebase for your application at the server side and at the client side. In the React application also, we have provided all the Firebase configuration in the ENV. So if you can see, all these are the Firebase configurations. So what I will do is I will create a new application. We'll populate all these environment variables and then we will see our application working for the login and the sign up. And then we will go to the restaurant page and we'll fetch all the restaurant details. Restaurant details will be coming from this restaurant microservice, this Swiggy microservice. But before that, because this is a logged in user, he is going to carry the authorization header. We have to validate the authorization header through this Gatekeeper service. Now this Gatekeeper service currently working as an authentication service. It can also act as an authorization service. So currently we are logged in with a simple one role user, but there can be admin, restaurant owner, end user, like there can be multiple roles. So that thing also we can populate and then that role will be validated through this Gatekeeper service. And based on the role only we will allow user to access these particular set of microservices. Okay. Let's see that in the live and what we will do is in the next video, we will populate all the environment variables from the Firebase. We will see the current state of the application, what all are running, what all not running, and then we will stabilize it and then we will build some APIs part after that. Okay. Thanks everyone. And sorry for the delay in this particular playlist because I was keeping the priority higher for other playlist and somehow forget to carry on this one, but let's finish this this weekend, guys. Thanks, everyone.